By now, I'm guessing you've heard, we're just days away from a total solar eclipse. This is when millions and millions of Americans are going to see the moon block the sun, or at least part of the sun. Washington correspondent Maddie Beer-Temple reports on how the nation's capital now is gearing up to celebrate it.
There's an eclipse party planned for your nation's capital, hosted by NASA and the Smithsonian Air and Space Museum. Marielle O'Brien is an astronomy educator at the Smithsonian. She's been studying the skies for more than two decades.
It's a really nice situation where a large swath of the U.S. is going to be able to view a total eclipse.
At the Solar Eclipse Festival on the National Mall Monday, visitors will be able to view Washington, D.C.'s partial eclipse at about 3:20 p.m. when 87% of the sun will be covered.
It's actually the result of what we call a cosmic coincidence.
It'll be really impressive to see kind of like Cookie Monster taking a bite out of the sun.
Anita Day with NASA says an eclipse happens when the Earth, Moon, and Sun all line up.
Total solar eclipses happen about every 18 months, but often over oceans or deserts where no one can see it.
That's what makes this one special for viewers in the U.S.
The moon is about 400 times smaller than the sun, but the sun is about 400 times further away than the moon, so they appear to be roughly the same size in the sky.
O'Brien says more than 31 million people live in the path of totality. That's where the sun will be completely covered for a few minutes. Even if you don't live in the path of totality, you're still in for a show.
It should be spectacular.
But Day says don't stare directly at the sun. Make sure to wear eclipse glasses, which you can get at some libraries, museums, or online.
Those are thousands of times darker.
The next time a total solar eclipse will be viewable in the U.S. will be in 20 years. In Washington, I'm Maddie Beer-Temple.
Yeah, the big event right around the corner. And as eclipse watchers look to the skies on Monday, there's new technology out that will allow people who are blind or visually impaired to hear the celestial event. It's a device, it's called light sound, and it translates changing light into the sky into sound. And when the sun is bright, it plays high flute notes. As the moon begins to cover the sun, the mid-range notes are those of a clarinet. And darkness is rendered by a low clicking sound.
It's going to be inclusive, and having any technology that makes it possible for us to have an experience, an actual experience, rather than somebody simply describing it to us, is always fantastic.
That is pretty cool stuff. Organizers of the Light Sound Project plan to distribute hundreds of devices to locations holding eclipse events all across North America.
That is very cool. Mm-hmm. Well, Kai, you said we're going to have very sunny skies, but probably we're so far out of the path, we may not see much.
Well, I've studied this, and we're going to see about a 50% in terms of...
No kidding.
Yeah, the totality. So we'll get a good shadow coming through here in Southern California. It's going to take place during the 11 a.m. hours as we head into your Monday morning. So we'll talk about that momentarily. A real quick shot at Huntington Beach. What a beautiful shot. Plenty of sunshine. And this is what we're going to see on Monday. So, again, if you're going to get outside and take a gander at that, but of course, safely, well, this is what you'll see, clear skies. Let's take a look, however, at the cities, the areas throughout our country that will have 100% totality. Once again, you're seeing Southern California skirting that 50 percentile on the left-hand side of your screen, but it's the areas beginning down in Southern Texas that are going to see 100% totality. We're talking about Austin, Texas. Houston, they're in there. Dallas, Little Rock. We'll make our way through Memphis, Springfield. We'll head further to the northeast up into Indianapolis, Louisville, Cincinnati, Columbus, Fort Wayne, and then further up north towards Buffalo, Cleveland, Burlington, Albany. They're in there for 100% totality. And we'll make our way up north in towards Canada, Quebec, and eventually out towards Nova Scotia. And we'll see it eventually, of course, moving out towards the Atlantic and towards the Scandinavian communities. But again, we'll see a little bit of that shadow coming to Southern California. So that's going to be quite interesting. And of course, we'll have that live for you here on KTLA on Monday morning. Here on